Émile Durkheim's The Division of Labor in Society is a foundational work in sociology that delves into the fundamental question of how societies maintain coherence and solidarity amidst increasing complexity. Written in 1893, Durkheim's analysis remains pertinent today, offering insights into the dynamics of modern societies. At the heart of Durkheim's exploration is the concept of the division of labor, which he sees as central to understanding the structure and functioning of societies. Unlike earlier theorists who viewed division of labor solely as an economic phenomenon, Durkheim argues that it has profound social and moral implications. He contends that as societies develop, the division of labor becomes more complex, leading to a shift from mechanical solidarity to organic solidarity. Mechanical solidarity characterizes traditional, pre-industrial societies where individuals share similar values, beliefs, and ways of life. In such societies, social cohesion is maintained through a strong collective conscience, where everyone performs similar tasks and adheres to the same moral code. Durkheim illustrates this with the example of primitive societies where the division of labor is minimal and individuals are bound together by their likeness. In contrast, organic solidarity emerges in modern, industrial societies characterized by a high degree of specialization and interdependence. Here, social cohesion is not based on similarity but on mutual dependency. Durkheim argues that as societies become more complex, the division of labor becomes more specialized, with individuals performing distinct roles and functions. This specialization fosters a sense of solidarity based on the recognition of each other's interdependence. Durkheim highlights the role of education and the legal system in promoting organic solidarity. Education, he argues, socializes individuals into the values and norms of society, instilling a sense of solidarity and collective identity. Similarly, the legal system reflects and reinforces the division of labor by regulating interactions between individuals and ensuring cooperation and mutual respect. However, Durkheim acknowledges that the transition from mechanical to organic solidarity is not without challenges. One significant concern is the potential for anomy, a state of normlessness and moral confusion that arises when there is a mismatch between individual aspirations and societal norms. Durkheim identifies rapid social change and the breakdown of traditional institutions as factors contributing to anomy, which can lead to social disintegration and instability. To mitigate the risk of anomy, Durkheim emphasizes the importance of moral regulation and social integration. He argues that while organic solidarity may lack the rigidity of mechanical solidarity, it requires effective mechanisms for maintaining social order and cohesion. This includes fostering a collective conscience through shared rituals, values, and symbols, as well as promoting social bonds through community involvement and civic participation. In conclusion, Émile Durkheim's The Division of Labor in Society offers a nuanced analysis of the evolving nature of social cohesion and solidarity. Through his examination of the division of labor, Durkheim illuminates the complex interplay between social structure, culture, and individual behavior. His insights remain relevant for understanding contemporary societies and the challenges they face in balancing diversity and unity.